period, Jim.
Hello? I wasn't going for that sticky, sweaty look when I got dressed this morning.
You have a future in cleats,
which I don't.
Is it just me, or do they all look like they're posing for cat ads?
Which leaves me,
Lizzie McGuire. Not nerd, not jock, not brain, not rebel, not diva. I guess you'd say I was D, as in none of the above.
His name is Danny Kessler, and he's the closest any of us are ever going to get to Brad Pitt.
See? Again with the hormones. Most of it coming from my mom. She's being so great. Maybe I don't give her enough credit. Huh?
80!
Big deal!
No! See? That's why it pays to let your parents yammer. Every once in a while, they hit on something you really need to hear. So, maybe I missed the defining event of my adolescence. But then again, maybe the defining moment is realizing that there really is no such thing. Yeah, that's it. Okay, I know what you're thinking. Me, Lizzie McGuire? Cheerleader? What up with that? I mean, nothing could be more superficial, demeaning, and shallow. Cheerleading is like this plot to make girls feel bad about themselves.
But I hope I make it, I hope I make it, I hope I make it!
I had no idea it was going to be this bad. Alright, that's it. I am so out of here.
McGuire?
The only thing worse than my cheerleading was nothing. At least I didn't try out for javelin.
Ow!
No big at all. I merely cemented my social status to that of a nobody for, I don't know, eternity? Here we go. Pep talk number 243 from the mother-daughter handbook. It's not that what she's saying is so bad. It's just that I've heard it 17 times already today, which makes the whole thing even more pathetic than usual. I can't believe I'm standing here letting Miranda take the rap. What am I made out of, jelly? On the other hand, how lucky to have a friend like Miranda who handles conflict so well. Who am I to deny my best friend the thing that makes her happy? I think I can. I can't. Please don't ask me what's wrong. Please don't ask me what's wrong. Please don't ask me what's wrong. Ha! I knew it. Mom's not perfect. She only pretends to be. Never laid a glove on me. Okay, this is so not okay. Believe it or not, when I got ready for school this morning, I wasn't aiming for leprechaun chic. If you're wondering what happened to me, we had to go all the way back to this morning. But basically what happened is school picture day. Not a problem. I couldn't possibly look like Brittany for at least 5 more years and like 5 million sit-ups. Maybe because it's hideous and it makes me look like a cookie elf. It can be a little tough when one of your two best friends says things that are kind of bizarre. When both of your best friends do, you just learn to deal with it. Throughout the animal kingdom, it's a well-known fact that the males fiercely compete to establish themselves within the herd. But in middle school, girls get in on the action too.
Outfit, outfit! Who's got the outfit?
Lisa Chung? No, she blew me off.
Allison Gendel? She smells like feet.
Tamara Scarpatti?
Oh yeah, like that's gonna work.
Now she hates me since I sat on our Titanic lunchbox in the 5th grade. I'd rather die than go crawling to her.
Your shoes suck!
Why is Kate being all nice to Ed? And what's he doing with paint? I know, Kate's got a plan. She's hired Ed to whack Miranda's outfit. Miranda worked hard for 3 months to get that outfit. Her picture will be ruined. I can't believe it either. But Miranda would jump on a paint grenade for me. Besides, green's very in this season. And it's not like I was the only one whose picture came out weird. But like Ordo says, I'd rather be a good person than look good in a picture. Besides, I liked the way I looked. I know what you're thinking, but I have this situation totally under control. I've been packing for this overnight science field trip since, like, last year.
Am I insane? I can't pack that. I might as well pack the pink ducky pajamas. Here's the lowdown on our trip. Downside, bugs, snakes, and my science teacher, Mr. Pettis. Upside, 48 hours in the woods, parentless. Just me, Miranda, and Gordo. It's like Survivor before school credit.
Disappear once in a mall when you're six, and you're branded for life. If humiliating me were an Olympic event, my mother would take home the gold. This is not happening. This is not happening. This is not happening. Not happening.
McGuire's a common name.
Maybe people will think it's a coincidence. Guess what? You can die of embarrassment. Tonight on Lizzie Vision, when good moms go bad. My mom just high-fived my best friend. And the worst part is, she actually thinks she's being cool. At 6:27 on Friday night, my mother destroyed what was left of my life. Forget the boys. Mom's getting earthworms in her bunk tonight. Okay, just when you're ready to trade her in for a new model, your mom does something cool, and you realize she's pretty much the coolest mom in the whole world. The next Monday at school, my mom was pronounced coolest mom ever of all time in the history of the universe. Sometimes you do get the best of both worlds. A cool mom and a parent banned from all school field trips. Surprise, another B. It's not bad, it's just a B. Boring, bland, blah, blah again.
Ever notice that everyone seems to be great at something?
See what I mean? All I can do with a soda can is recycle it. Gordo's in search of his next documentary, and I can barely take a Polaroid.
And floppy shoes and a red clown nose.
Well, that's just perfect. I find the thing I'm great at, and it's the stupidest thing in the world. What's next? River dancing? Thank goodness my best friend would never leave me alone with Coach Kelly. Maybe it's time for that best friend talk. Lou to Azur. I'm good at burping. But does that make it a sport?
That was almost a compliment. Maybe I should think about this.
Well, if it isn't Miss Clubfoot.
What's bothering me is I'm trying to win a gold medal in Geek.
Note to self, bring extra hoop.
As for my destiny, well, let's just say it doesn't involve ribbons and hoops. I'm thinking more along the lines of first woman president, space explorer, Mrs. Matt Damon? Whatever it is, I'll keep you posted.
How we feel? Doesn't that sound a little new agey? Ooh, do I smell incense?
Mr. Pettis can slice and dice a frog in formaldehyde faster than you can say, Fidihana!
The downside is, he gets kind of wigged out about all the homeroom paperwork.
We've been test bubbling since like kindergarten. Why do we need the instructions every time? I guess three times is tonight's quota.
My dolphin paper? Okay, the margins were a little wide, but it had to be at least four pages. Go ahead, ask me what dolphins eat.
Ah! Lame as that joke was, I always make it a point to go along with it when teachers try to get a laugh.
I'd rather be hoarse.
Typical. The marker always runs out when you're almost done. One of the laws of science projects. Another one says you can never find the scissors when you need them.
Maybe I haven't thought this whole switching projects thing through.
I don't usually pull this sort of stunt. But Gordo's in trouble and it's partly my fault. And when I was younger, I did climb a pretty mean tree. I have to say I'm relieved. I'm not gonna rule out cosmetologist, but it's nice to know my options are still open. Plus, hairspray kind of makes me dizzy. I give Mom and Dad props for that one. They convinced Matt to take back his name without humiliating him, and the whole time, they respected his boundaries as an individual. What kind of Jedi mind tricks are my parents and teachers working on me? Oh well, I pretty much trust them. Maybe I'm better off not knowing. At 13, you'd think I could run and talk at the same time. Ah! I'm going to Aaron's party. Tomorrow, I have a date with Destiny. What am I gonna wear? This is a cinch! I can snoop out secret video shoots in my sleep. I don't remember calling in Toad Boy for backup. Just when I thought I was out, he pulled me back in! That's it, Matt's going in the bag. Wow, Monkey Boy makes sense. We're going in, and this time, we're not leaving anyone behind.
No problemo. I can do four things at once.
I think the plan is to make it up as we go along.
That's it. I'm dressing as an elf from now on.
That's gonna leave a mark.
I got nothing.
She's eating out of the palm of my hand.
Ow! Find out what he sleeps in.
My once-in-a-lifetime chance is gonna come around.
Once-in-a-lifetime chance? Check. My life is now complete.
Looks like we're all invited to Aaron's party. Everyone except for me.
Wait up, you guys! I want to be in Aaron's video, too!
I think I'm getting a nipple here.
Ooh, I'm really getting a nipple here.
Ta-da! After 13 years, trust! Wow, for the first time in my life, I'm in charge. I'm the ranking adult in the house. I'm queen of the world! I hate it when Dad's right. They're admitting they were wrong?
What?
Call the news crew! Film at 11. So the more responsibility I ask for, the more responsibility I get stuck with. That stinks, I think.
Yeah! Let's overthrow the ruling powers. I don't have a good feeling about this. Okay, a little out there. Gotta love her, though. I mean, look at the way she still cuts the crust off my PB&J.
Hey, who was that? Wait, that was me.
Not bad, I think. 9 votes? Pour moi? They like me. They really, really like me. I would never swallow worms for votes. Somehow, that doesn't sound better than swallowing worms. No, Miranda's right. It's a lie. Okay, when is someone gonna stop me?
Coffee?
Okay, ready to change back now? Ready? A little help here. Oh, it's too late. I'm alive. Okay, so I lost the election. No big. I just hope I didn't lose my friends. Phew. Glad that's over with. In the immortal words of Kermit the Frog, it was not easy being green.
Yeah, where's my bachelor number one? Mr. and Mrs. Larry Tudgman. Mrs. Kate Tudgman. Kate Saunders Tudgman. It's all good. This is great. I could be married to a tree frog and still have a better marriage than her. Ethan Kraft, Ethan Kraft, Ethan Kraft, Ethan Kraft, Ethan Kraft. Gordo's cool. Yeah, I'm seeing it. Best friends equals best marriage? Mix those two together and we have a recipe for victory. No paper for us this weekend. Yes! Okay, so she's my best friend. So I guess I'm happy for her. But this is so unfair. Okay, so I've met vegetables brighter than him. But he is a total hottie. Mrs. Dr. Ethan Kraft? That's not a rock. It's a continent! I'm not jealous. She's Mrs. Dr. Ethan Kraft. I'm married to a trash man. I'm not jealous. Okay, nice that my parents like each other, but gross when they kiss in front of me. Ugh! Kate? Ethan? Probably totally innocent. Wait, it's Kate. Definitely not totally innocent. I would give a year's allowance to be any place but here right now. Maybe 2 years. I am so erasing his name from my notebook. I'm not a coward, really. It's just not the right time. Ugh, I am such a wimp. Not only am I a wimp, I'm a jerk. I'm batting 2 for 2. Unless I'm on a train and it's taking me to a private rock concert with me and my friends, I'm just not that interested. As if word problems aren't enough trouble. I'm forced to learn about them while my life is in constant danger. Detention? Detention? But I've never had detention. I am a good girl. Good girls don't get detention. If I'm train A and Angel's train B, we're about to have a major collision. If I agree with everything she says, maybe she won't hurt me. Still alive. Seems to be working. A band? Bands rock. Angel's not scary. She's misunderstood. Why didn't I think of that? I should tell her the whole ugly truth. How I was unjustly thrown into detention, locked up with the bad kids. She'll take my side. I'm her firstborn. First detention? Now I'm lying? What's happening to me? Okay, so maybe Angel is a little dangerous.
But a little danger never hurt a girl.
Ow!
So long, good girl.
Hello, Frizz.
Everybody can calm down, move on. Nothing to see here. No parents? High school boys? No parents? It's getting kind of warm in here. Note to self. Next time I walk on the wild side, wear comfy shoes. Ah.
If I had one, I'd be Lizzie Warrior Princess. Lizzie's got game.
A plan this simple has to work.
Ha! Ooh, should have seen that one coming. I'm a rock. I'll never crack. I'd like to see a lawyer.
I just think she get her own talk show and broadcast it to the world.
No, not happening. I am not running into my cute English teacher in the you-know-what department! Shouldn't he be home handling grammar emergencies?!
This has got to be enough to get me into the witness relocation program. Is there some kind of rule that Kate and her posse have to witness every moment of misery in my life? I need Mr. Snuggles. They forget to sign your field trip forms, forget you don't like liverwurst, but they never forget when they give you cash. My work here is done.
Hi-ya! Gordo is definitely not everybody. He's always doing something different.
I hope that means thanks for the good advice, here's $20.
Ethan Kraft is so totally hot. I hope this isn't stuck this way.
Great! I finally get a chance to talk to Ethan Kraft, and he thinks I like the music that my great-grandmother listened to.
I've always thought so, Pally. You gotta hand it to the kids at our school. They sure can jump on the bandwagon.
It's a good thing Gordo's CD wasn't banjo music. Everybody would be dressed like hillbillies.
Well, 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 well. Little Miss Popular needs our help. Looks like the shoe's on the other foot. But she's gonna have to beg. She's gonna have to get down on her knees. She's gonna have to grovel. Oh! Just what I need, a hairball. Not into it? That's nuts!
Great. I ruined Gordo's hobby, and I ate a cat hair cupcake.
I think I gave him something to think about. It's that stinking Gordo, that's why. He's a dirty fink, and he's bringing us down just because he thinks we stole his hobby. I say we let the crybaby cry. Get that out of my face, you punk!
On the other hand, he invented Barbie Freeze Green, but he was poor, so he sold the patent to Edison.
I think Mr. Lang is way over journalism. It seems like he'd rather be somewhere else. Wow, Miranda's officially in love with acting. Maybe when she's 30 years old, she can play a teenager on Dawson's Creek.
Yeah, right. Blech.
Okay, I can do this. I've got words in my head. Come on, words out of my head. Out! Out! Ooh, Scranton! That's a city in Pennsylvania. What stinking good does that do me?
Hey, don't slide away from me, Miss Thing. I'm trying to be the nice one here.
Hey, I shouldn't even have to apologize, Miss Queen of Stinky Acting.
Well, you're a lousy friend too, and a stinkbag actress.
Impressive. I hate this. She's showing me how to be a better friend to Miranda. And she doesn't even know she's doing it. I think Mom might be a witch. Glee Club? Singing? Oh no. Singing. Just when you think Miranda's hit bottom, she gets a shovel.
I'm not meant to play.
Good for Miranda. I bet if I keep looking, I can find the thing I'm really good at too.
Matt must have been switched to birth. My real brother couldn't be some prank-pulling, lizard-killing, make-believe friend-having weirdo.
I want a blood test.
Hysterical? Who said I'm hysterical? I'm not hysterical.
Poor Dad. He tries so hard, but most of the time, he's clueless. Poor Mom. She's got Dad so well trained, she actually believed that. It was nice while it lasted. Ugh. That Ethan guy? Is it too late to put Matt up for adoption? What am I gonna do? I'll do what any other red-blooded sibling does. I'll go to Mom and Dad. Somebody wake me up, please! Anybody wake me up from this horrible nightmare! This is really happening! That's it! Matt's going down!
Woohoo! Yeah!
What?
I just can't win today.
Now I've made him even more popular. Oh, I could kick myself in the head. Wow, I didn't know I could do that. Matt ruined the best phone call of my life. It's not over. I'll get him. I totally have a knack for this. I ended world hunger in an afternoon. Okay, maybe not ended, but I made a dent. I totally rule at the saving the earth thing. Maybe this is a little more complicated than I thought. Well, if my parents' generation wasn't so interested in bell bottoms and roller disco, the planet would be in a lot better shape. Typical mom. I'm talking about saving the world and she's talking about laundry. Tree killer. Wow, this is getting really heavy. That's not good. Can I keep him? Can I? Dad's right. Matt's family. We've got to have each other's backs. We've got to be all about love. On the other hand, the little rat stole my scarf! Say hi! It's not that hard. How you doing, Ethan? Good morning! Yo, dog, what's crackulating? Okay, good start. Next time, just say it while he's still here. Cute and smart. Like Albert Einstein, only without the Three Stooges' hair. And I can impress Ethan. And I can be with Ethan. And I can hang out with Ethan. I just have to be able to talk to Ethan. See? Send an amateur to shop, and that's what you get. Nothing. I'd like to see you do that handcuffed to your little brother. Finally, there's a reason for Matt's existence. The best part of this is, it's not a dream. The worst part, it's CPR class. Kiss me, you fool! This is never gonna work. This is never gonna work! This is never gonna work! It worked? What? I like volcanoes! Okay, I didn't buy an $8 ticket, but I'm spending 17 bucks on popcorn. Somebody besides me! I'm a hero! This could be my big break. Next, I'll be starring opposite Ben Affleck in Vesuvius 2. Or I could be starring in Grounded Forever, the Lizzie McGuire story. Gordo's got a girlfriend? And I thought the movie marathon was gonna be scary. Well, Gordo lied to me, went on a date, then kissed a girl without mentioning any of it to me. If I didn't know any better, I'd believe him. That's so Gordo. He'd get an A in lying. Hello? Hi there. Hey, I'm your best friend, remember? Over here! Oh, crud. It's useless. I feel like I'm in a dream where everyone wants to kiss my frog. No! If I just keep talking, no one will notice that I ruined Gordo's date. And that I'm ruining everybody's dinner. Gordo's right. I've done permanent damage here. As permanent as the spaghetti is stuck in my hair. Ow! I knew he'd come back. They always do. Way to be modest, Gordo. How can anybody read this? Cave paintings are easier to understand. Hello, Captain Obvious. It doesn't sound so good when he puts it that way. Guess I'll be going now. What? Truce. But I come in peace. Come on, you can get this. I know there are brains under that perfect hair. But for a friend, he's been saying some pretty mean stuff. When did my friends become more complicated than my math homework? Whoa! Hey, 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 hey! Yeah! I love the way Ethan says my name. Lizzie, 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 Lizzie! How hard is it to say yes to the cute guy? This isn't what I thought alone time with Ethan would be like. But look at that smile. I'm glad he didn't eat elephants. No! Lizzie, 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 Lizzie! How can I have a mad crush on a guy who thinks he aced a test with a 72? Oh yeah, that's why. Sponging off my cereal won't cost him a dime. Maybe he is the smart one. Hey, I want to be his little something. Oh, he likes color. I wear color. We're made for each other.
I love Miranda. She thinks of everything.
It means I am going to marry Ethan Kraft.
Gotta start somewhere.
Okay, that's never good. But whatever it is, I'm sure I can blame it on Matt. Daddy-daughter date night? He is definitely reading one of those books.
Just when I think I'm happy to see him, Mr. Jig has to go and get all mind-gamey on me.
Ethan!
Uh-oh. He's actually picking out some fancy restaurant. The kind where they serve ketchup on a plate.
Okay, I'll break it to him easy.
Oh no, he's making this difficult! Wow, Dad's actually being cool. Without even trying. I hadn't thought of that. I've been busy planning a wedding.
Why do I suddenly have a heavy feeling in my stomach?
Whoa!
I gotta stop having these talks with Mom.
Enough! I can't handle all these questions! That's funny, you rock too!
We are so perfect for each other.
Okay, so maybe this isn't the fanciest restaurant in the world. But as long as you like the people you're with, ketchup on a plate's really not that bad. What's your point, Gordo? We're gonna be on TV! I don't know what he's talking about. I'm ready for my close-up! Smoking! And we're all going along for the ride. A leading man is tall, dark, and handsome. I guess one out of three isn't so bad. Bye-bye, Gordo. It was nice knowing ya. Gordo! He's alive! Wow, looks like there's a new sheriff in town. How soon he forgets the little people. Conflict? I think conflict is when my nail polish doesn't match my outfit. Share? Friends always share. Mom watches a lot of cop shows. She always gets me to fess up. Ugh, I hate it when she tells me what I already know. Some alternate universe whacked out alien version of yourself? That doesn't make me feel any better. What a shame. I guess we'll all just have to hang out and be happy. Like that's gonna happen. Thanks a lot, Gordo. What's next? I've got a great personality. Can it get any better than this? Yes, it can. Well, who's laughing now, Miss I got axed for stealing supplies, and now I sell hot dogs in front of the lumber for less? Who's laughing now? Maybe I don't want to spend all my time hanging out with cool kids in hot tubs. What? Am I delirious? I must be cracking up. Wait a minute. I always wear this blouse. My earrings match my eyes? I need rubber boots with all this manure she's shoveling. Since when does Ethan Kraft turn into jelly around me? Ew. She said we. I was right here. I heard her. Problem not solved. Problem huge. My friends are turning into freaks. This is horrible. Gordo and Miranda aren't my friends anymore. They're my people. Stop staring at me. I'm not a celebrity. I'm a human being. I like substitutes. They teach you useful stuff. Commence Operation Superstar Brat. My friends are back.
This is it. Matt's going down.
Oh, crud. Here come Mom and Dad. Hide the catapult. Great. I get a brat sit my little brother. Talk about scary. Trick or treat. I would look so slinky and cool as a vampire. I am so tired of wearing Mom's old marching band uniform every year. No! I am the desirable vampire. I get to wear the slinky outfit. I get to... Okay, I'm gonna need about 8 gallons of concealer for this. Do you believe Kate? She's phonier than cafeteria cheese. The truth is, if Matt did get spirited away to the realm of the dead, who's gonna be in trouble with Mom and Dad? Me. Guys, thanks. Job well done. I wonder if the Glee Club is ever going to perform a song that wasn't a big hit during the Civil War. There. Completely focused. I cannot possibly study 4 extra hours a day and still have time for the important stuff. This is really going to be a sacrifice. Cash me out. I'll be at the buffet. Alas, poor Kate. Har, har, har. The Titanic didn't go well. This was a disaster. All we did was talk like old English weirdos and eat turkey legs. Queen Elizabeth was fat, bald, and looked like a clown. You can look it up. A crush on me? I'm the crush E, not the crush-er. Larry Tubman? Nerd times pi.
Never! No way! Not in a million years! No, nope, nix, yet!
Lying is perfectly legal in a case like this.
I don't feel guilty. All right, I feel guilty. I'm obviously desperate. That's not the answer I was looking for.
Well then, Larry Touchman must be really amazing.
Yeah, but if I don't do the right thing, fast forward to the disappointed speech. I didn't even know I had social status, and that was going to be ruined. It's not too late to hang up.
Sometimes I wish I lived in the Stone Age.
Way sweet. He actually does look cute. Is this the Tudge? Yeah, it's the Tudge.
Well, at least no one I know will see us here.
I'm actually having a good time with Larry Touchman at a science museum. Have I entered some kind of alternate reality? Right, icky interests. But the thing about Touchman is, for a dork, he's got a lot of self-confidence. Who's the dork? I freak if I wear the wrong shoes. Intercepted pass! Of all the days to be fake dating Larry. Ugh. Now if my life in danger to do the right thing. Stop before you break my heart.
Prepare for waterworks.
Maybe I should develop some interest. Then I can join a club and meet a boy there.
I never thought I'd say this.
My mother was right. Great boys do come in odd packages. I could pass a new law making Ethan Kraft worship me. And I guess I could feed starving people or something. But Ethan Kraft would be job one. Dear Gammy McGuire, thank you so much for the cool present. Next time, please send cash. Whatever happened to hide and go seek? Simple game, you know, you count to 50, I go hide. Ideally with Ethan Kraft, on a yacht. Didn't lose interest in his pigeons, a cat developed an interest in them. Yikes! Okay, I see what the problem is. Gordo died a few weeks ago and didn't bother to tell us. Gordo's back! I mean, he still obsesses about stuff, but at least it's good stuff, like sports and junk food. And helping me with my homework. Suddenly, I don't feel so good. Nurse! Why is it the school's only fun when I'm not there? Give me the bad news, Doc. I can take it. What did I expect? Oh, that's really bad news. The CIA has got nothing on the United Mom Front. You don't work with Kate. You work for her. Negotiations are tricky between hostile forces. But I accept her demands. Easy for him to say. He doesn't have to cook with Katezilla. Ow. What do I want you to do? I want you to build a time machine. Go back to yesterday's class when Miss Stebble asked who's going to be Lizzie's partner. Raise your hand! That's it. The gloves are coming off. Whoa. Did we just agree on something? That's scary. Face it. She's a cheerleader. I'm not. You just can't upset the natural order of things. Experience of my life! Okay, it was kind of fun. Wow, when separated from the she-beast, Kate reverts back to human form. But when backed into a corner, she-beasts come out fighting. Whoa, it's like deja vu all over again. I know, she got popular. Strike one! Strike two! Strike three! And you're out! I really think things were gonna change? After all, this is junior high. She loves him, she loves him not. She loves him, she loves him not. She loves him, she loves him, she loves him! What am I saying? I have no idea what to do. Flattery goes a long way. Bye-bye. I thought I was the one who got bumped on the head. Hey! Hey again! When I'm good, I am really good. It's in the name of love. Get with the program, Gordo. Like I said, when I'm good, I'm really good. This is the worst idea I've ever heard. There is no way I'm doing that. Okay, that's it. Gloves are coming off, walls are coming down. I'll show you who's shy. Love is so complicated. Is there some sort of law against serving anything edible in this cafeteria? It's just so hard to wait.
Ooh, how did I not see that coming?
What'd she do? Fail nap time? I'd love to stick around, but I got a thing. Ow! Incoming! Why do we have drills for fire and earthquakes, but nothing for when your two best friends declare war on each other? Maybe it's tying his film together, but it's pulling me apart. Okay, you can stop now. I can't stretch this far. Told her? Why couldn't someone have told me? I got it. It's a movie about an animated character. She's smart, she's funny, and Brad Pitt is totally in love with her.
It's a wrap.
Guys, I'm not done yet. Guys? Oh, to be that helmet. At last, after years of conversation, I finally stumped him. Elizabeth? My mom doesn't even call me that when she's mad at me. Okay, a little help here. Gordo's usually the one with all the answers. Open up! Look who bucks our steak. Food, bringing people together everywhere. L'chaim. Really serious. He didn't even get my sarcasm. What's his rush? Girls mature faster than boys anyway. Hey, that means me first. Me! Yeah, like I'm really going to talk to my dad about what's going on in my life. Well, when he asked so nicely. Blight? I knew we didn't speak the same language. Good advice and ice cream? Maybe I should talk to my dad more often. Which is exactly the way I like him. School is actually a reality game show. People get voted out, and just when you think you have the rules figured out, they change. It's out of nowhere. A school-wide epidemic. The love bug. And everybody's bit but Miranda, Gordo, and me. Great. Cone of silence! Cone of silence! I believe the words are self-explanatory. I have a boyfriend. A boyfriend! A coolly, coolly, cool boyfriend! Well, it's not gonna be me. Hallelujah. What was the last thing I ate? Please let it be a breath mint. I have the right to remain silent. Anything I say can and will be used against me in a court of law. I'm watching too many cop shows. She has a point. Rewind! Green screen law. And in the category of most embarrassing moment of my life, we have a winner. This really, really hurts. Eating junk food with your friends, watching TV while your brain turns to tapioca. This is what America's all about. What we have here is a failure to communicate. He's cute, but he understands even less than Ethan Kraft. That's exactly what I was gonna guess. Doesn't sound as good as a free trip to the water park. I knew it. My parents are from outer space. How come Ethan Kraft can't be from Mexico City? Money? Prizes? I'm up. I'm awake. This way, I can do research for my report about foreign culture and win fabulous prizes and dinero. Now that's a homework assignment that relates to my life. Good thing Miranda knows more about her culture than I know about being Scottish, Irish, German, Dutch, Polish, and whatever else I am. I have to learn about half the world. Come on. We gotta find the rest of Gordo's bullfighter suit. I have a feeling cuidado means either look out or Blondie's about to get squashed. Don't make him go away. We need him. Okay, I've got about 30 seconds to brush up on 1,000 years of Mexican culture. What does that mean? I must have soaked up some Spanish in my life. Nothing. I am totally lost. I have no idea what to do, and people are laughing at me. Quit laughing. What am I, a clown? I'm here to amuse you? No. Or what to do with the box and a bunch of rice pudding. It's like being laughed at and covered in rice pudding is what it's like. Why are they groaning? I like reading. Harry Potter, Eloise, books about cats who solve crimes. It's schoolwork you can do lying down. That's so beautiful. Hello, when are you guys gonna grow up? Grow up! And? She can drive! That's a plus. How smart am I? Mom didn't fit into my world, so we're friends in our own little world. Sometimes it's like I'm too perfect. Well, almost perfect. When I say you can tell me anything, I mean too much information. Grandparents don't split up. Grandparents give you money when your parents aren't looking. I like being friends, but why can't we just make pots and cut out all the drama? No more! No more! Woo! and she tracked me down. The kind of stuff I'm ready for is, how do I get Ethan Kraft to like me? And am I having a good hair day? I'm barely ready for that. The cheerleader table is like the Oscars. You only go if you're nominated. Sand? I don't even like the beach. Where's a big gust of wind when you need it? Since when do I control the wind? I wanted Kate put in her place, but I didn't think her place would be eating alone on the ground. I hate monster movies. People like me don't do well in monster movies. I think it's safe. Kate? In the dork hallway? It's like I'm in another dimension. Wow. Without cheerleading, Kate has no superpowers. What are these strange feelings I'm having? I'm feeling sorry for Kate. I never thought this day would come. I'm going to help Kate! Note to self, never lose my friends. Look at her. She's harmless. Looks like my bunny grew some bangs! We gave her back her superpowers. Now she can crush us again. What was I thinking? Oh no, not again. I'll take humiliation in front of the whole school for $500, Alex. Not to me, but hey, it's a start. I knew the stroganoff was going too far. Last time I tried to feed it to the dog, and we don't even have a dog. How can you argue with that? I guess that's how. Give them the sad eyes. They can't say no to the sad eyes. Yeah, well, your stroganoff tastes like an old shoe. An old smelly birch shoe. 4 more years? Don't I get time off for good behavior? I can clear plates. I do that at home for free. Maguire's batting 1,000 on the job front. This job thing rocks. I'm free. I'm independent. No one tells me what to do. I'm free. I'm independent. I just have Dragon Boss breathing down my neck. Around Kate and Claire, there is no such thing as an accident. Apologize to Kate and Claire? I don't think so. I'm free. I'm independent. I don't know which is grosser. Having to apologize to Kate and Claire or cleaning up melted smoothie off the floor. Ugh. Here it comes, the responsibility lecture. Who are you? And what have you done with my real dad? Now I know why no one else applied for this job. I've had all I can stand and I can't stand no more. I think that qualifies for the understatement of the year. One little mistake and suddenly we're not talking. Whatever happened to best friends forever? Oh, he's so cute when he's confused. Finally, I get to pick my partner. Which would be a whole lot easier if I was talking to the two people I usually partner with. One minute I'm showing him how to work the water fountain, and the next we're partners? Buried treasure? Go back, go back! Oh, it's Miranda. I hope she's calling to make up. She totally called to apologize. Let me think a minute. Not even. Put the hand down. We're in a fight, remember? I hate fighting with my best friends. I can't believe my ex-best friend just called me a cheater. Whoa! Was that Mr. Dig? Fighting really hurts. No! But I'm gonna win this race if it kills me. I'll tell you what happened. Which is okay with me because I'm fine on my own. Did Ethan Kraft just say something smart? Maybe he really is as perfect as I think. He's got a sense of humor, too. Or does he really not see that that's Mr. Dig? Like it should be. I miss Gordo's sense of humor. Although, that's probably not a joke. Ha ha! Run! Why even bother making plans? I obviously exist just to watch Matt. Blah, blah, blah. Watch Matt for the rest of my life. Be miserable. Blah, blah, blah. Got it. My parents aren't paid enough to do this job. Go back! Do over! Rewind! Great, now he remembers. Where's a time machine when you need one? My little brother and his friend are missing. We killed my dad's prized possession, and I have an English test tomorrow. Things couldn't be better. The only thing that's worse than having Matt and Lanny around is not having Matt or Lanny around. It really depends on your definition of okay. This plan better work. I think my parents might notice that Matt's missing after a couple of days. Well, Mom will notice. Ruin Dad's football, ruin our lives. Not exactly hard to remember. What is this weird feeling I'm having? I'm worried? And you better have a good answer. Oh, that's a pretty good answer. It's not over. Nothing is over until I decide it is.
Let's see. Destroying a football, chasing Matt and Lanny across town, and sneaking back into the house without getting caught. Yeah, it was fun. So close, yet still so busted. Mom's taking this really well. Not fair. That should be a penalty on Mom. Unnecessary grounding. And I take my job very seriously. Yes! How mad can I get? I mean, face it, most of the animals at Dolphin World are smarter than Ethan. Please say no, please say no, please say no! This is it! I'm about to dive into the waters of romance. Ah! That's right. He wants a party girl? I can be a party girl. He wants artsy? I can be artsy. He wants intellectual? Oh, who am I kidding? Ethan can't even spell intellectual. A drop of grape soda, a teaspoon of salt, a pinch of Oompa Loompa, and presto. Okay, the formula needs some work. Maybe a dash more Oompa Loompa. Here we go. All Mom wants to do is interfere in my life. Hey, I guess she doesn't want to interfere. She just wants to tell some pointless story. Be mysterious! Be mysterious! That was mysterious. I have no idea what that meant. Because who really needs unclogged arteries anyway? And the great thing about that is, I'm 14, so I only have to deal with this stuff for another, like, 80 years. There's the silver lining. Call France looked terrible on me. Yeah? Why didn't you say so? Why didn't you tell me changing to please Ethan was never gonna work? Wait, my diary says you did. Well, never mind. They don't want to control my life. They just want me to be happy. See, if I were still Ethan's type, I would have no idea how to do this. Just when you think your outfit is perfect, you find last week's pizza stain. Ugh. Which is kind of weird because it should have been washed in last week's laundry. Which means something bizarro is going on with my wardrobe, and I don't mean my blacks don't match. This could only mean one thing. Well, maybe a little. Why do I suddenly look like Matt? This isn't my room! Oh my gosh! I am Matt! But today's actually a really good day to buy it. Not telling you about? Okay, that's it. I'm telling Mom. But I am his sister! Huh? Life as I used to know it is now officially over. If I just sit here quietly, maybe no one will notice me. Get in trouble? I'm lucky I even knew how to find this class. This is so unfair. At least at home when Matt gets in trouble, he deserves it. This is a conspiracy against my brother. Think you. You're never gonna believe me. They believe me! Wow, Matt's really gross. Wait a sec, I just understood Lanny. Did his lips even move? Kid's got a point. Great! No detention! But will I be stuck this way forever? Make that three of us. And to top off the worst day of my life, the worst night of my life, I miss my bed. Woohoo! I'm back! Oh, I miss me so much. If he's not saying, then neither am I. Yeah, volleyball. That's it. No! Thanks, folks. I'll be in Atlantic City till the 23rd. I like the exercise and being out in the sun, but these dungarees cut me across the hips. Miranda wants to play it this way? Fine. I'll fall into Ethan Kraft's arms. This is working out all right. Maybe this isn't working out so good. Can't move. Oh, in pain. Oh, the hurt. Looking back on it, they might have been smart just to practice at least like once. What? I'd rather be run over by a herd of elephants. Okay, I take that back. It's bad enough when my parents teach me about life, but when my skunkhead little brother is a better friend to Lanny than I've been to Miranda, then I've totally hit bottom. And I'll just quietly bury myself. Gold. It sounds so much better when he says it. Didn't get the memo. Stick a fork in you, you're done. I should have invested in municipal, high yield, small cap. I should have gotten a piggy bank. Gordo? Curly fries? And when that doesn't work, Mommy! Why do moms think that hot chocolate fixes everything? Because it does. Not helping. Continue. Go back to talented, then stop. My road dogs, they've always got my back. Maybe it's time for a new set of road dogs. Slow down! I'm tying as fast as I can. No!
I have a need for speed.
You like me. You really, really... what's the next line? Oh, yeah. You really, really like me. Emergency subject change. Eject! Eject!
So, how do I do it? Not according to my shoe size. Okay, 2 out of 3.
Oh, no, he didn't. Puppies, that could be my new career. Dog groomer, dog walker, veterinarian, nail polish for dogs.
But first, I will have to answer the age-old question, who let the dogs out? Woof, woof, woof.
There's my hand. Oh, that counts.
A budget? I couldn't possibly be on a budget.
I'd run out of money.
Great. The car gets new shoes before I do.
It's called Style Shack for a reason. I'm not gonna be voted best dressed wearing last year's rejects from a bargain basement. I can't lie to my mom, but I can't wear bargains. Ooh, where's the button for lower than low? That's how I feel. Wow, not hideous. Not Style Shack, but not hideous. And I'd like to thank my mom and dad. And the Style Shack. These are bargain basement pants, people. But they are kind of cool. A new pair of hip huggers from the Style Shack, $65. A more popular pair of hip huggers from Nell's clothes closet, $12.95. An afternoon hiding toilet paper and laughing with my mom?
Hey!
Priceless. The problem isn't that I don't have a date, it's just that Josh Hartnett doesn't go to this school. That's the most important part. Decorations are the most important part. Think twice before volunteering for anything. Beheading the school principal does not solve problems. It causes them.
Hey, you kids, cut that out.
Kate did it. Kate. Did I say that? Great, one head in your backpack and suddenly your friends start looking at you funny. How can she be so guiltless? We? How did this turn into we? I didn't even do anything. So why do I feel like I'm in so much trouble? Maybe it's because I still have a head in my backpack?
I gotta stop eating right before I go to bed.
Don't do it!
I hope I did the right thing. Apparently looks can't kill because I'm still alive.
Okay, guess I'll have to spell it out for them.
7th grade. Been there, done that, outgrew the t-shirts and donated it to charity.
No, really, I don't need the props.
I do it because I care.
Hey! Star light, star bright, lots of starry stars.
Why does this keep happening to me? Did I just say that to Ethan Kraft? This really is a new me. I really like this girl. Have I mentioned how much I like this girl?
I love this girl! Hello? I thought you were president of my fan club?
That's better. I hate to say it, but I'll say it. Who am I kidding?
I love to say it!
Well, okay. People are confused.
Hey, who is that? And why is she wearing my clothes? Imposter, what have you done with my Gordo? When did my whole world turn upside down? Ah! Ah! Role model, schmole model. I want my life back. And it's freaking me out!
You know, space. Like the distance between here and Pluto.
Get lost, get your own life, get real and deal.
Okay, go directly to freak, do not stop at normal.
Hello, emergency, I want to report a stolen life.
I'll hold.
That's it, no more Miss Nice Guy. I mean, girl. Tense, I'll give you tense.
Mr. Dick is a great substitute, but he scares me sometimes.
Okay, he scares me all the time. Does life get better than a love scene with Ethan Kraft?
This is officially my all-time favorite play.
She makes it sound like it could never happen.
This is the part where the alarm clock always goes off. We're from two different worlds, just like Romeo and Juliet.
And look how they ended up!
Uh-oh, I just felt a disturbance in the force.
How many times does opportunity have to knock before I answer? Me three!
Oh, I bet that's why he's wearing a disguise.
Oh, is that all?
Who thought dating someone famous would be this complicated? Oh yeah, I did. Dating an actor is overrated anyway.
Wow, I must believe that.
We're girls, we can multitask.
Okay, Gordo's making sense, but Miranda? Besides, I'm sure the president would be calling on line one anyway.
Are we looking at the same picture?
Hello, it's called airbrushing. Nobody in the real world looks like that. Okay, so maybe it's just a stupid paper fortune. But I like what it's saying. Starvation diet? Please. Or 15. I'm pooped. I knew we should have taken 5. If I didn't know any better, I'd say that someone's stomach is growling. Either that or... Okay, something serious is going on with Miranda. She's not eating, practically fainted, and just lied to my mom. It's times like these when I just have to say, help! I'm just wondering what Miranda sees when she looks in the mirror, because it can't be what I see when I look at her. I hope so, yeah. That's right, I'm in over my head with all of this Miranda stuff. I know when I need a professional, and I'm not afraid to admit it. Sheesh, what do you do when your professional starts to freak out? Mom can be really smart sometimes. I'm glad I take after her. Little Gordo. Some things never change. I've totally changed. Just look at me. All right, bad example. Last poor Gordo. I knew him well. Something they want him to do? Of course, Gordo's a secret agent. Suddenly it all makes sense. No one could be that smart in junior high. Wow, the only thing cooler than secret agent is high school student. You're a smart guy? Gordo sure doesn't know what high school is all about. Leave us behind? That's not cool. I like the way she thinks. La 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 la, can't hear you. Great, Gordo's leaving us and Miranda's already throwing his going away party. I'll give you 2 good reasons.
They're standing right in front of you!
They... something! Last chance! Say... something. One friend abandons me, and the other supports him abandoning me. I'll just stand out here in the rain, alone, without a jacket. Yeah, but what about me? What does it look like I'm doing? I'm here being happy for you, you big goof. Ask him! You know you want to. Like me! Come on, take the hint! How did someone so clueless get moved up to high school? I'm happy for him. I am really happy for him. Leave it to Mom to get a Lifetime movie on us. I hate being right. What? Just ask him. Ask him again. Ugh, he is never gonna get it. Just tell him. Tell him! I can't believe I missed him so much. Why did I miss him so much? Whoa, if they keep this up, they're going to see my breakfast. Now, maintain, McGuire. Calmly explain to her how important this is to you. How can I enjoy being a kid when I can't go to any cool parties? A minute in jail! This sounds like it involves a little bit of lying and deception, but a whole lot of going to the party. This plan is genius, sheer genius, I tell you. She knows. How does she always know? Okay, it's official. I am the worst daughter who ever lived. It's hard to tell through the frosting, but Kate does look upset. This is going nowhere, and there's a big cookie at the mall with my name on it. Not entirely true, but these are the times when I love her so much. And then there are times when she really, really scares me. Survival of the fittest? I'll never make it! Hey, that is gonna leave a stain. What is she afraid of? She's going to break a nail or something? I knew it! I should start playing the lottery. The world, according to Kate, is really warped. We're never gonna get out of here. Who is she kidding? Like, I'm the kind of person who would do that. Well, a manicure may make me feel better. No, finally, I have something on Kate. She snores. All this backstabbing and conspiring could prepare me for a career in politics. Cool. Uh-oh. Tag, I'm it. Duck and cover, duck and cover. Yay, I cleared my name. Okay, I really need to work on some esteem issues. He was asleep when I took it, but still, especially if that's Freddie Prinze Jr. waiting for me down there at the bottom. No, it was a moose. And we're off to a great start. What are you looking at? Hey, I don't care if you have the Dallas cheerleaders living here, as long as my float gets done. Count me out. It's too bad Santa's helper can't take a shower until New Year's, but I've got commitments. This could still be the best Christmas ever. It'll be a lot of work, but I can still grind everyone else into the dust. In the spirit of the holidays. But what about my float? I can stay awake. I can finish this. I can take a little nap. Even when my mom is the ghost of Christmas past, she has to hassle me.
I can't tell if Gordo's putting me on or if he's genuinely clueless. Either way, I'm gonna smack him.
Even if I could think of a brilliant comeback, I'd still look like a rat searching for a contact lens.
Sometimes with younger siblings, you just have to be patient and diplomatic. But yanking their drawers up to their belly buttons can be a big time saver.
So far, I'm not wild about how Operation Lizzie's 11 is working out.
Next time I perform, I want an announcer, a spotlight, and someone to catch me!
There, that was a good cover.
Oh, perfect.
Ouch! She's getting mom involved. I never thought about it, but parents have to be con artists. How else would they get us to eat our vegetables or go to bed on time or send thank you notes for crummy presents we've already exchanged for store credit?
It's true. I mean, pictures fade and they get torn and stuff spills on them. And your haircut looks really dorky. But memories last forever.
Foreign intrigue? Internal affairs? Gonzo journalism? A big fat nada?
Great. Now he decides to stop being brilliant. That was actually helpful. Maybe I don't give Miss Du enough credit. Or maybe not. Oh, I've got plenty of advice. Just nothing I can say out loud. Either these kids have me confused with Santa, or a lot of people need help at school. It's really more of a calling. Memorize everything about this moment. Gordo just called me brilliant. If pretty good and covered in leftovers are the same thing, I'd hate to see what not so good looks like. Dear Lizzie, what do you do when the advice columnist runs out of advice? I think I just did. I want to run home and hide in my bedroom under the covers with hot cocoa and Mr. Snuggles. I don't want to go on sabbatical! One more letter. I can do this. No one will end up hiding in the garbage. Delete! Delete! Although the Kate fantasy wasn't so bad. That's it. This amateur advice columnist is going to the pros. That's the thing about dads. You think they're clueless, and then they just surprise you.
I know what you're thinking. This is all a dream that I'm about to wake up from. Well, you're wrong. Bet you didn't see that one coming. I know bugs get it when they eat spicy food. Ethan's brain may have melted already, but the rest of him still looks mighty solid. Bam! Inspector Lizzie already on the case. So what's Gordo doing crowding in on my clue? Swish! Nancy Drew couldn't have handled that any better. Come on, you know you'd want it too. Oh no, Ethan's the smart one in his family. Look at Gordo. He's being so immature about me beating him. But what if Gordo's not being immature? What if Kate's right, and he really does want to win to impress me? I can do a lot with my head, but I cannot get around that idea. If I named the wrong suspect, I could let Gordo win. But if I do that, does that mean I like Gordo? Well, I guess we're gonna find out. Okay, it doesn't take a detective to figure this one out. Kate's right. Gordo likes me. So, it looks like Gordo likes me. But he's just my friend. I mean, that's how I've always thought of him. I'm all for school unity, as long as it doesn't involve Kate. School painting project. School car wash project. School cleanup project. Hey, wait! Maybe Gordo's right. Oh, no, she doesn't. I paid in the school for free. Mom's not roping me into doing the front door, too. Hey, I am the child with the most seniority here. I deserve some respect, and I deserve it now! Please, when is the mothership gonna come take Touchman home? Of course not in the corner. There's room in the closet. I know what Matt needs. His own room. Bend? There's only so much bending I can do until I break. And I think I'm gonna be stuck with Matt forever. Mom and Dad brought him into this world. Why can't they take him out of mine? It's not a mural of togetherness. It's a mural of making Lizzie feel like a loser. You know, after seeing Miss Dew's mural of togetherness, the whole thing about which group put their handprints where didn't matter much. I'm not a big fan of gym, especially basketball. But when the opportunity to guard Ethan Kraft comes up, you take it. True, but it's worth every second. But if he was cute and smart, he'd be super Ethan, and I don't think the universe is ready for that. But I am. Me, 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 me! I mean, I don't care. Whatever. It's probably true, but he doesn't have to say it. Parker complimenting Gordo on basketball? You don't think... Nah. One compliment and Parker's in? I compliment Ethan every day, and he's never asked me to a dance. He's so nervous. It's like alternate universe Gordo. Oh, it's so cute. I guess being a guy is harder than I thought. Gordo, 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 Gordo. too. I hope he didn't tell the King of Norway joke. He's the one doing the asking, and I'm the one who's nervous.
That girl's got some splaining to do.
That's not a reason. I can't go because my cat died is a reason.
It's a good thing Gordo doesn't care what other people think.
Or maybe not. It's like we've switched identities. Hold it right there, partner. I don't think you're telling the truth. And the award for bad timing goes to...
With the way she treated Gordo, she's not anything.
What do you do when the person with all the answers is the person with the problem? I should start paying more attention. Sometimes we all forget that Gordo's human, including Gordo. We've made contact! Gordo is in the building. It's the three amigos back together, and I wouldn't have it any other way. Gordo's back. Gordo 2, Parker Zip. It looks like everyone got what they wanted. So why am I not happier?
Great? Grubby Gulch is great the way a rattlesnake is cuddly. It's the lamest old west tourist town ever. A weekend at Grubby Gulch? I'll stay in here. Thanks just the same. I have no idea how I'm gonna repay these guys. I guess I can let Miranda borrow my clothes anytime she wants, and I don't know, I'll probably have to marry Gordo.
Because this is dorkful. It's massively lame. It's the definition of cheese master. And every minute I spend here makes me more lame, cheesy, and dorkful.
You know, I can see how Grubby Gulch could actually be a pretty cool place.
She's Miranda. But remember, you're talking to me. Let's keep our focus where it belongs, Popcorn Boy.
I didn't do it, Your Honor. You can never prove it was me.
Give me a sec. Take the coefficient, subtract that, carry the 5. Yes. Yes!
I did something nice for Matt.
That doesn't sound like me.
That sounds like me. That's got me written all over it.
I'm ruining Mom and Dad's weekend and running off to the mall. Way to go, me.
That's what I should be saying. Why am I not saying that?
Say it! Say it! My brother's in a food coma. My parents are wearing stupid hats and I'm acting like a goon. You know what? I'm having a blast! Oh, there are limits. Okay, this is why I have a strict rule against blind dates. Allow me to translate. Wow. Squire McLizzie. Blitzwire McMick. Izzy McGizzy. Hey, that came out right.
And he has blue eyes you could just drown in.
Oh, that stinks. Talk about depressing.
He likes me. Ewan likes me.
Oh, my love is like a red, red rose that's newly sprung in June.
Splendid work. Now, I'll grow up, marry him, and we'll split the Nobel Prize in... rhyming things.
So why is Miranda sniffing around my future husband?
Aww, Miranda has a crush on Mr. Key.
Miranda must be destroyed!
This is ridiculous. Everybody knows he's mine. And I'm gonna win this cat fight. You hear that, Miranda?
Interesting.
It's 904 pages of dull.
But if I want to be Mr. Keith's favorite, I need some kind of a gimmick.
So I can spend time with the most wonderful man who ever breathed and become Mrs. Most Wonderful Man Who Ever Breathed.
Huh? Mom actually gets it?
Would you believe there are no greeting cards for that?
Appetizers and a compliment. I really like her. She's got a point.
Oh, I hate him.
Yep, that should win me a few points down the road.
Did she just call me Matt?
A mistake like that's gonna cost her.
Weird, I know what she meant.
Could be worse. She could have brought him frog's legs. Oh, yuck.
Yep, life is good.
Well, since you are acting like such a baby.
And he'd probably crush me.
Okay, ready for Mom and Dad to get better now. He's also getting kind of annoying.
They don't know!
That's one way to look at it.
Fine, I was 4 years old. Couldn't pronounce grandma, so sue me.
She may be out on a limb, but at least she knows when to climb back down.
I really am.
Just when you think you've gotten away with something?
Who am I kidding? I'll never get away with anything as long as I live. Priorities, woman! Priorities!
And Britney Spears' makeup artist. And Jennifer Aniston's costumer.
Oh, and don't forget Josh Hartnett's home phone number.
Hey, it's gotta be a perfect party, right?
It's basic math, really.
It just doesn't sound right to me.
I wish everybody ended with you.
But it's Miranda's party. It's gotta be perfect.
A little white lie won't hurt.
I can't believe she bought that junk.
Maybe I should look into a career in acting.
Who says I can't think on my feet?
Unless, of course, my cover story is immediately blown to pieces.
That's totally cool. I'd hate to see what he looks like upset.
Just ask him and get it over with. If he really doesn't want to go, then You have nothing to feel guilty about.
Funny, that no sounds a lot like a yes.
Note to self, no more parties for Miranda. I love having brilliant friends. I just hope Larry doesn't turn into a pumpkin while Miranda's watching.
If it was gonna be easy, then it just wouldn't be Larry!
I guess that's just part of his charm. I wish Gordo would disguise himself as someone who was helping.
Uh-oh!
This is the part of doing the right thing that I always hate. This is the part of doing the right thing that I always love. I guess happy endings don't just happen in fairy tales. They happen in real life, too.
The only thing better than talking to Ethan Kraft is talking to him in two languages.
Actually, maybe it's best if he didn't speak at all.
Like when you're out of cash at the mall and the skirt you want is on sale.
Yeah! Like I never heard that one before.
If my best friend is the one with the credit card, why am I paying? Oh, who am I kidding? It's still Gordo. Life's so unfair. Did I just invite Gordo over for fashion tips? Just call me desperate. Where's the car chase? Where's the action? Where's the monkey? Even though I know that, it's always nice to be told. Okay, I know he called me brilliant, but I don't remember saying anything about using his credit card to make a movie. Just remember the little people along the way. Well, when he puts it like that, whatever that is, life sure was easier when we were broke, living on planet Earth. I hate it when Gordo's mad at me, but what I hate even more is not having Miranda here to talk to about all of this. Next time she goes on vacation, I'm going with her. Maybe Gordo really is a good director. Ethan looks disgusting, which totally makes no sense, considering Gordo and I are best friends. Yeah, so psyched that he doesn't want me involved at all. Now see, if Miranda were here, she would totally get it. Fine, if he's really gonna make me spell it out for him. Did Ethan have to get ugly to become so smart? That sounds right to me. That makes no sense. Why can't my parents be like that? Actually, maybe that's not so bad.
Uh-oh, did I just sound like my mother? I'm too young for that. If I didn't like him so much, I'd hate him. Did I just invite Mr. Dig to dinner?
But you're not supposed to see your teachers outside of school. It's like seeing Santa in blue jeans.
What? Who said that? Because I know it wasn't me. That's what I'm trying to figure out.
And I don't always have control over when I'm going to crush you.
At least none that they know about.
Note to self, get two new best friends. Oh, this can't be happening.
Digby Sellers?
No, you're Mr. Dig. Mr. Dig!
Is it time for him to go yet?
And you can call me Mortified.
That's a question definitely worth repeating. And I'd kind of like to hear you leaving.
What? That is the worst thing I've ever heard.
What can I say? Gordo's totally right, as usual.
As if I don't know.
That's it! My father and my teacher cannot be friends anymore. It's interfering with my life.
No! That's not fair! Mr. Dig got home from school before I did.
That's it. Time for Operation Breakup. And to add more fuel to my fire, I don't need a homework monitor. Oof! Hey, it's my soda to offer, not yours. Please say no. Please say no.
Not really.
It was also clear before we started talking.
Yeah.
Our friends?
The only thing harder than asking Mom for help is accepting that Dad and Mr. Dick are friends.
I hate being so mature.
He's young. He'll learn.
Matthew?
Okay, here's a lull. Gordo and Miranda said to avoid them because someone might say something embarrassing.
On second thought, maybe some of Dad's friends aren't so bad.
I can't be the presidential something that Lizzie's good at challenge. Hanging from a bar isn't a real useful skill, but it's not exactly gym death.
What?
Ethan has left the building. Time to pack my bags. Guess who's taking over the White House in 2024? All in a day's work.
Am I game?
If being game means flag football with Team Hottie, then I am totally game. I am like the most game there ever was. All right, this is weird. Ethan's usually the one who's confused. Nobody scores on my watch. Finally, the cute boys notice me.
Yeah, the cute boys notice me because they think I'm one of them.
The guys will high-five me, but they won't hold my hand.
Okay, they want a girl? I can be a total girl. I'm going to be the girliest girl they've ever seen.
Okay, I need one part clueless and two parts legally blonde. Watch out, world! Miss Lizzie McGuire is ready to make your acquaintance.
Tore up the field? I chewed it up and spit it out. I totally rocked, and don't you forget it.
Who are you calling a girl?
Oh, that's me.
Kate's gonna be invited to prom, and I'm gonna be invited to monster truck rallies and chili burger belching contests.
Yeah,
Nice job of permanently ruining any chance I may have of a social life. But I like that explanation. It's hard to believe teachers even exist outside of school. Let's play some football. That's something you don't hear very often. It just took some time for this girl to figure out that she was gonna play. Did I just say choo-choo? Oh, but so did Miranda! And that's why we love them. And more to the point, Next stop, Clover and Daisy. Ethan Kraft is in my room. Ethan Kraft is in my room! And I'm in pigtails. And on my way to see Clover and Daisy. He's cute. I can't help myself. In the history of embarrassing moments, this one's the gold. Oh, please tell me she's here because she's a major fan too. Gordo, I've had enough of you and your positive attitude. There is nothing positive about this. There is no stopping my mom when she wants to have a heart-to-heart. I like pink, and I'm standing up for it. Whew, that worked. If it didn't, I was going to insist that mom and dad sell the house. And clearly, a lot of these people do not rock and hopefully will change. Does that make me a bad person? I'm going to high school, I'm going to high school. Oh no, I'm going to high school. Nothing. A second-class citizen of Loserville, USA. Population? Me. Dad shield activate! Come on! This is so way serious. And my dad's laughing. Hello, I thought we were talking about me here. Let's focus, people. He has to say that. He's my dad. I am so smooth. It needs to sound casual, but yet non-obvious. But obvious in a subtle way that we're, like, gonna get married. Soon. Note to self, bring a flashlight. Well, a little peek won't hurt. That is so sweet.
Just like that. Day is high, but I'm holding on. I'm gonna be your number one. But I'll wait right here till it's my turn.
A dead guy. Maybe I'm an outfit repeater, but you're an outfit rememberer, which is just as pathetic. Run! Okay, I am not, under any circumstances, sharing a room with, yes! Okay, I was wishing for smooth sailing through high school, but this'll work. What's the word for yes in Italian?
Did you just say cool cheese?
What? CNN? Wow! How famous do you have to be before you need a bodyguard? Italian, but I know what that means. Ouch! If I didn't have a headache a minute ago, I do now. Jewelry. Now that's a language every girl understands. Okay. Diva, good. Tacky, bad. I'm ready for my close-up. You'll never make me talk. I wish to thank everyone who's always believed in me for this great honor.
Don't speak to me in Italian.
It's too adorable.
I'm not gonna try it. Now you know things are bad when Kate starts making sense.
Prince William? Tell him he'll have to hold.
Of course I can do it. This is moi we're talking about.